Okay, Falashay. Thank you for being my body. Okay, so we're going to start with footwork. All right. So, if you're coming to Pilates V, heels together, toes apart. Right, almost high. Shoulders about, knees about shoulder width. There you go. Okay, now, nice and broad across your collarbone, okay? Nice and firm on the upper arms. Heels together. I feel like you've got Velcro there. Take an inhale, bring the carriage out. And exhale. Nice inhale through the nose, nice and deep. Open your mouth and exhale. Out with an exhale.
Yeah, do you feel how that breath stretches?
Three, look at the knees. Four. I want to see how far we can get, so instead of saying three. Excellent. I think heavy pelvis, six. Resist the springs coming in. And seven. Right across here. Exhale. Bring your feet together and your knees together. Come onto the arches.
Yeah.
Using your inner thighs. Take an inhale. Bring the carriage out. And exhale. Nice and heavy here. Nice big exhale. Open up and exhale. Really exhale. Inhale. Fill your lungs completely and exhale. Good. Four.
Alternating ones, and I was sick for a while. Let's leave that out.
Let's keep resist the springs coming in. Six.
Girls are in unison.
Take a nice big inhale through that nose. Exhale it all out. Seven, last one. This time. And exhale. Okay, bring your heels onto the bar.
It's really cute.
Right? And stretch. Inhale, bring the carriage out. Or heels on, rather. And exhale, come in. So I'm going to stand here. I want you to have something to press against. Use those inner thighs as you come in. Good. Keep squeezing the knees together, even the upper inner thigh.
Good. You figured that. It starts
four, but come away now.
Yeah, you started out using your inner thigh. Good.
Five, inhale.
So now you're going to get your arches.
Exhale, heavy pelvis.
Stretch. Parallel. Long wide pressed out. So this is a lot of inner thigh. Knees
more fallacy.
Trying to hold your knees together. So press out. Good. And one solid.
Okay. Set up for the 100. Bring it into your chest. And then put more for
Okay.
So back onto the balls of your feet. And inhale, bring the carriage out. Lower the heels. And lift the heels. And stay out there. We're going to do that 8 times. Inhale. Try and feel a little bit more back here, Falashay. Okay. Bend your knees just a tad better. Right. No, good. This is looser. No, not that much. Yep. Keep going. Two more.
Yeah.
And now bend your knees.
So this is like
perfect. Okay. Hands back to the handles. For the 100. So make sure your wrists are punching and take an inhale and extend your arms and your legs straight out and curl up. Straight legs and start pumping those hands. 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale.
Yeah, and your
bigger inhale. Bigger exhale. Inhale. Two. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 30. I'm pressing here. I want you to press against my hand. Right. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 40. Can you bring your fingers together? Yes. Curl them around there. Yes. Feel like you're punching them. Right. Curl up a little bit more under the bra strap. I'm going to remove my fingers. Feel like you're still pulling in against them, even though they're not there. Exhale. 60. Inhale. Exhale. 70. Inhale. Take a hold. Ownership of those legs. Okay. Engage your legs completely. Look the car up. Exhale. Inhale, three, four. Exhale all the lungs, all the air out of your lungs, and bend your knees and your arms up. Now, we're going to go straight to coordination.
Short spine. I got other things. Never mind. Okay, set up for short spine. You want to do that? Okay, thread your straps. Right, and then short spine. Going to lower you down to two. And while you're there, lift your head up a little bit. You're going to lower that. Okay. Now try and bring your feet up. Try and lift your bottom to put your feet up in there rather than pulling your straps.
Yeah.
Do your best. Good.
This one you keep your legs straight.
Extend your legs straight out.
Yeah.
And now with an exhale, bring your heels together, come up. And now
inhale towards the shoulder blocks.
Open the knees towards the shoulder blocks. And roll down. So let's get the breathing now. Okay. So it's going to be an inhale, squeeze my fist here. Stand in those straps. Exhale and bring the foot stand up. Stand in the straps and the straps come up and over. Round it all back. And inhale, and exhale down. Good. Get on your own. Make sure my fist is there, even though it's not. And exhale. Nice big inhale, curled over yourself. And exhale, one vertebra at a time down. Nice and rotate over the back. And again, inhale, three. Stand in the straps, come up. Exhale, open the knees to an inhale. Right, and exhale as you roll down.
Kelsey, I'm
going to
say
something and try not to change the movement about what you're doing after it says. Watch her arms. Inhale. We're going to do it again, and what I want you to do is feel like you're pressing into the carriage with your hands, okay? And that your whole arm is engaged against the carriage as you come up throughout the whole exercise. Right, not curling your fingers up. Right, and better. And exhale. Now, grab a hold of the wood inside your legs. Grab the wood inside. Yeah, and pinch the straps from the inside out. Flip them up off of your feet. Slide down, and we're ready for coordination. Right. Take an inhale and extend everything up as out straight, arms and legs.
Curl up. Think about the transition. What's the first thing that happens?
70
Curl up.
Yes.
And out.
Right, before you set
up. Yeah, set up before you go.
Right. Okay. So,
90 last time.
Okay, let's make believe that we just slid through, okay, and you're ready. So now, curl up, and inhale and extend everything straight out, arms and legs. Open, close the legs, and pull the knees in, and exhale. Okay, I want to see that inhale through the nose. Inhale. Open, close, and exhale. Hot and deep. Inhale. Three. Open, close the knees, the legs, and bend. Elbows right. Four. Open, close. Pull in, right, and exhale. And last one. Inhale out. Open, close, and exhale. All right. So, put your handles on the pegs. Okay, Kelsey.
And those straps here, separate your knee up. They will always stay cutting my up. They will always stay inside your knee.
Right, everybody's favorite. So sit really close. Okay, on these pads, close to the foot.
Think about, is there a way for you to just lower your heels down?
Your hands are gonna come on either side of the carriage, and all the way out on the side of the carriage.
And then,
so slide them out. Yes.
That more.
Flip on the foot bar and slide
the knees down.
Can you feel? Yeah, come up onto the ball.
So you're here.
Good, so already you feel a lot of ground is here. Not your chin, just a little bit more.
And then as I can, I wanted to.
So, take an inhale, bring the carriage out.
So actually, we'll
stay out there, lower your heels, lift your heels, stay lifted as you bend your knees. So already, just try and feel a little bit more open here. Curl here.
The whole area has had some trend.
So careful with your placement on your right hand.
Yes, so you feel it.
Just listen to every second, Ajay, if you don't mind. What are you seeing that you want to change?
There's too much roundness here. I want this to come up, and I think she can access that if this is one more.
Yep. So lean forward a little more, Ajay. Yep, shoulders over hips. It's easier to find in the out position. And then really elongate in the waist.
Shoulders or hips elongated in the waist.
Yeah, so rather than saying don't round your, not just so this, but rather than thinking don't round the upper back.
Say what you want.
Yeah, finding what you need instead.
Got it. Lower the
and then she'll inevitably lose some of that on the way.
Right. Lower the heels, lift the heels.
Hard to balance.
So shoulders over hips elongated in the waist. Right. And exhale.
And the other place
helps
that
so then
when you do that, kind of a little bit of traction. Yes, because I'm seeing this particular on this side.
Which is
the
result of her heart. So getting elongated here, and then lifted here.
Yes, you're more.
Right.
A little bit lifted.
I've never done that, so that's
kind of a gyro. Is that okay?
You have to pull right side and then kind of open out.
Lift and exhale. Okay, now holding the carriage in, bring your hands back on the shoulder blocks.
Try to
keep your feet on the back bars.
So sometimes I think
you're
in
five. A little bit. Okay, so this is flat back. So again, here, shoulders over your hips. Take an inhale, pass out.
No.
Lower the heels, lift the heels, and exhale.
Yeah.
So, nice big inhale.
Ajay, how's the thing on your shoulders?
And that has to do too.
Actually, take your hands. I feel like a big stretch getting back there.
I want you to see if you can sit. Okay, actually, bend that.
You see how the head of her humerus is rotated down? Take your hands down to the mat.
That really moves this.
But even if she can get there with her hands out, it's not doing any change. The shoulder is
right.
What you need for push ups.
So, exactly. Pull up now.
Okay. So inhale. Bring the carriage out.
This gets tall.
Lower the heels. Cross here and up.
There you go. And so breathe.
I don't need to hear it, actually. It's not about that. I'm not sensing it. And last one.
There you go.
Oh, that's what's going on. Now you tell me.
Okay.
To come right into this.
Super breathy.
Okay. Well, we'll get into it. Okay, by the end, we'll be good. And bring your arms forward for arch reaching. Okay. So what I want you to feel is that your arms are hugged into your shoulders. Okay. And you're broad across here. And take an inhale.
See if you can move.
Inhale, press out. So low, bring your hand, palms against mine. Okay, that's it. Yes. No lower lift. So can you feel a little bit longer in your midsection? No lower lift. Right, just straighten the legs.
What is your intention with your right hand?
I'm trying to get to fix this.
We're trying to draw our shoulder blade back.
Yes.
Is that clear? So there might be an okay handle. You just need to give her a little bit more information about what you're
doing. About what I'm doing. Yes, that's it. That's where I was
trying to plug her in.
Right, trying to plug her in. Right. And exhale forward. And it's still wrinkled open here. It's right at the end of it. Yes. Inhale. And exhale. Which is not the last one on this next one. You're going to do the twist. And so you're going to twist to the right. And you're going to look at me. I'm going to press against my hand here.
So try not to cross your midline.
Okay, so now you're going to do the exact same thing.
It should be right on your shoulder. Your hands are
back. So this is going to stay.
Okay. Yeah. I tend to press more and more because I'm not feeling it, but that's not
so just
helping.
Hear the word, push harder.
So push harder here. Push harder against my hand. And exhale.
The difference?
Yeah.
Good.
And it's not very good.
Press harder. Now staying forward, arms above your knees, circles. One, two, three, four, opposite direction. And now to the side.
And what do you notice about our feet? Not that you need to correct them, just check them out.
They slipped down when the heels weren't together. The knees are too far. Okay, so, go to the side, two, three, four, and exhale.
Do you think she's getting a benefit?
And now see where those shoulders are. Okay.
Well, probably not as much as she could yet.
So I don't know if it's that whole.
Yes, I would work on the other pieces that you've been talking about. So when it would be something other than a massive hip flexor exercise. I'm inclined to send that one out often. For that reason, most people have a hard time doing that without getting really stretched. So you want to see the shoulder position really solid.
So let's get
the posture, good foot placement, all those pieces in place before you can really get
yeah,
to
the
end.
Yeah, I would agree, especially on the side. You're used to holding your side.
And here, instead of
the wall. I mean, but now you're going to use them. Yes.
Okay.
So, that would be really nice here. This is
here's such a fun box to attach from.
That's where you're standing.
Do you know where you have this?
It's
all the way out.
So much better. That was a lot better. Yeah. Two more like that. Yeah. You're going to exhale the whole way down. And then you chest the really go backwards. Yes, good. Okay. So when you're frozen, that helps you. Like your
big
ear. Exhale.
This
is so much better. So two more of those. Completely make your shoulders dead.
Okay.
That just makes
so it so inside.
Yes.
Thighs against the barrel. And bring your feet up onto the left part.
And then big deep breath in. All the way up. Now, imagine you're going to get really good.
Just like the right standing in the fountain. And bring your hands underneath your shoulders. So, nice and firm feet. Nice and firm thighs against the barrel.
Okay.
And now, pressure in your heels. Bring your belly in. Keep that belly turned on. Inhale, maybe you're watching a bug.
As long as you're
this will look
more. Just
inhale,
chest
up. Open.
Yeah. Okay.
And exhale, keep that belly in. Test how much weight you need on your hands as you come down. Press through the feet. Press through the feet. Press through the thighs.
Without
elevation.
Oh, wow. You know what you're just doing? Open your elbows.
Well, I'm not sure. She's done this before and gone into her lower back, so I want to make sure that's not happening. My intention is for her to test it and see if she can begin to not have as much weight.
And having her hands down.
Oh, so it's much better.
I'm afraid that putting her hands back sort of to the weight of her back might encourage her to go there. So that's what we talked about earlier.
Write that down without losing.
What does she need to be watching her stand most to be able to stay on her back?
What does she need to be thinking about most to stay on her back? To work the most to be able to stay on her back. Feet into the ladder and belly in.
Yeah, and the feet into the ladder is going to give her what?
It's going to help her find that extension.
Transfer her hamstrings and her glutes are engaged.
So that's a place maybe to.
That's a place on my cue is inner thighs.
So relax.
Instead of here.
I think I just like in between.
That brings the attention there instead of not taking it away.
You might. So you're really
just going to top down. Which is not just stretch down. It's really just So now you're going to take that exact same posture.
Yeah.
Two
right.
More.
If you feel back working and no belly, that's something. If you feel both working, you might
now,
check
if reaching your elbow,
in terms of changing the dynamics of the exercise, we hope we're doing
the rail out. And then pull yourself back up. Good.
Thank you.
So you did that. Okay.
So, keeping that in mind. Okay. Feet into the ladder and slide tight here as you watch your butt crawling up. The wall.
Really?
In
okay.
You
can always go like this.
When I get in there, that's a little tender.
Right.
Does that feel better?
Okay. So it's a change. There you go.
To have this turn off.
Oh, sorry. Your left hand.
Oh. Well, I was trying to think to have
more touching.
Yeah. More extension.
And if you were on your deltoid, when I asked.
Which is going to curve it more forward. And
or not give her any information about what she said. So you want hamstrings, you want belly.
It opened up.
So think about what you want her to do. Yeah.
I didn't have to tell you then. Right.
It's okay.
About
my lower back. Not while I'm doing the exercise, but just laying.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
Let's do one more.
Oh, wow.
So then you come right off.
It is amazing.
Find your
left hand. You can get a
bag. When she goes up, I want you to put your left hand on her belly.
Okay. So belly in and start reaching up. Press your hands.
I'm going to go inside for a moment.
So, what I'm
sharing
is
through the bar.
That's great.
So, it's never, and then let it go.
Look how it feels.
You did it right, but I didn't tell you. I don't want to get you there. It's like too much.
There is too much. Is that better?
And that's a good thing to be aware of there.
Right. Not everybody
really if you have more exaggerated motor doses being taken across the barrel, just be too much pull on the back.
Oh yeah.
The degree of change in angle. Did it help to have the hands on the low belly? Other thing, now that you're standing, that I would be mindful of, and this is anybody that's got a tight back, is it
safety
to take upper back
is
or
not
to overextend
back,
which is another place your hands could go if you feel like she's falling down here in the other belly.
That's about the right amount of change on that space. And all the work
on your side of the oxygen.
Oh,
think about it. You were going to do
that.
I mean, there's a real
reason
why it was easily effective. So now here with this, so it's a trim plane when you're in
that's
going to
see.
So you're going to stand.
Yeah,
confidence
there too. Yeah, and thinking about what it is I want and just going there and not making it too complicated.
Exactly.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Good. All right.
Yeah.
Okay, so. So the top of your shoulder will be at the top of the
stretch.
Now, push the carriage out.
Yeah, so the worksheet even gets going, Cynthia, what are some things you want to be thinking about in this exercise based on what you've already seen?
Well, I want to make sure she's got good inner thigh connection and that her legs are together and raised up, and it's coming from more the belly.
So does the abdomen extend the hip?
Yes.
Does the abdomen extend the hip?
Do the abdominal muscles extend the hip? That's hip extension.
Well,
so she's in flexion right now.
Right.
So what does she need to, hip extensors are the glutes.
Good.
So for her to lift her legs up, we need to be thinking back wide of her leg, very similar to what she just worked on here.
Mm-hmm.
She does need to have some belly turned on. It's more important what's happening in her hamstrings and her glutes there.
Okay. So the connection here between the hips and the glutes needs to be clear
solid.
And solid.
Yeah. So she doesn't go into her lower abs.
Right.
It's her abs.
Right. So, I mean, how do you cue the hips to come on? I mean, just say it like this.
Or...
Now, as you're resting down there, like you're good. Okay, now, you're
going
to come right down
to the edge. I want you to lift your legs up without putting more pressure into your right now. And it might just be, my concern is if she goes a lot, take your legs all the way up.
I like to start just sitting.
So I see the back of the rest.
Then, now, see,
the
power of what should I do there?
Lift that same pull into the back. Yes, your pelvis is going to stay still.
And then
drop. Keep resting, Patrick. What do you know about from stomach massage? What else you're going to need to watch for in her shoulders?
From stomach massage, the rolling of the humerus forward.
Yeah. Since you saw that, you can remind her here.
Right, right. Maybe a smaller range of motion and like that she's like in here, which is something that she needs anyway. I know. And I've had to work on myself.
Yes,
so.
You can think
and I see a lot of clients. Okay, so grab these, straighten your elbows. Come all the way straight up on the strap. Straight elbows. Hands along the sides of the wood. That's it. Take all the slack out of them. Okay, so same thing here. All right, we're just going to do three of these, and we might not go full motion, full range of motion. And what I want you to do is make sure that your shoulder is rolled back. Open. Okay, so I'll press up against there. Without pressing into my hands, engage your belly and raise your legs.
Okay, your right hand on the heel of your left hand under your belly. So you do want her to press into your hand on the right side.
And I think it's
okay, and belly in, pull the strap straight along the wood. Inhale, straight elbows. And exhale.
It's not like, do you notice how much less?
So, this engage and
watch. So, actually, but you can hear it.
Exhale. So, I'm not seeing a whole lot of movement in the shoulder, which maybe is good.
So look at where she ends up when she's in her most extreme range of motion.
I'm really focused on making sure.
Don't change anything, pal. Should I do another one?
Shoulders are frozen in one spot.
Right there, you see our shoulder is rolled forward and down.
Right.
And
it's just
so what I've been doing you to work on might be helpful with
right. And then
if your pull, don't go as much to just put your shoulders up.
Yes, yes, and now you have
and move from there.
It's almost like you're trying to push that far away.
And you might not have better.
And then there will be one
your shoulder
that much. Yes, and now you see how the
back you have been cueing me.
It gets going.
And this, it's like feeling
it turns on the
wrong
here.
Okay.
Much better.
That's enough.
And it allows her to get into some spinal extension. Whereas as soon as that humerus comes down, it's impossible.
Okay, slide your hands down to the metal part of the strap, right, just above that ring. Bring your arms back straight, like a T. We're going into T, right? Firm wrists and arms.
I can force them higher.
Okay, as high as you can. And same thing going on here, okay? Yes. And with an inhale, just come straight back. Nice straight wrists. And exhale. fist a little bit more.
My friend was laughing.
Okay, you know, so you had
my husband's son, or quite a bit.
It was just the they like, and I think part of that is the
put those handles back on the So, coming into the dead bug position, okay? And so, take the tension, the tension out of the straps by rolling up. And inhale, come straight up with your arms and legs. And around, circle around with your arms and your legs. Stand in those straps with your hands and exhale. There's a big inhale. Round.
Where
should
her
hands be right now? Where should her hands be? They should be pulled up more.
And our hands should be on our head. That should be
all of those kids
on our
heads.
But isn't it important that there be no tension here?
That happens from her curling up more.
Right, rather than
doing that. So this would be a modification, but the exercise should still got to come back.
Okay, even if there's slack on there. Because I've been cueing a lot to keep that tension all the time. That's less important.
The tension is most important when the arms are extended up. Most people are going to lose tension with the strap in this part. So when the arms are out straight, there should be no slack on the strap.
Right.
So you can right away press into it.
Okay. All right, let's go the opposite direction now. So hands towards your... at your head, right? So now we're going to come straight out first with an inhale. Straight out.
And where do our
hands need to be above your thighs.
On top
of the thighs, right? And now circle around, arms and legs. And exhale back to the start. And inhale, arms and hands on your thighs.
How can you support what you want here? So put your hands
circle around and exhale.
Especially right here. So we got one more in you, Falchion.
I think so.
Reach your arms forward. You said you take your left hand around and hold under your head.
Doesn't it feel good?
My left hand around. Oh, pull it on her head.
All the way back. You also might not reverse it.
Yeah.
You're not seeing the curl you want in the first direction.
Right.
If you have some advancement to reverse it, so you might only do five in one direction and really work on that piece.
Yeah. Yeah, I find I'm falling into the pattern of, it's like I want to do the exercise the way...
On the list.
In the number and all that, yes. Right, instead of, really, this is about what this body needs, what Falchion needs right now.
Yeah.
And is this serving her?
Yeah, and in your test, if you get to a decision point like that, you could say, I know technically I'm working towards reversing this, but I think she'd get more out of doing all the reps here.
Right.
I think in the testing environment, as long as you're clear about...
Right, the reasoning.
Your choice.
Right. And then if it's wrong, we'll talk about it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So.
And so we're thinking about you.
Teaser. So, first thing you want to do is come back onto the box.
Yeah. Okay, so really how hard you can tell how hard.
Good.
That's good.
That's good.
Right.
So. Arms straight along the back like this. Like this, extending out. Bring your knees into your chest. Now, rest your head back. Open up, so nice and open.
Head down the
okay? Good. So, now,
so that work, that
Take an inhale and curl up as you begin to exhale and bring your straight arms up along your sides and up like you're coming up out of the water. Okay, so take an inhale and exhale, pull up. Oh, good. Bring your arms parallel with your legs and exhale down. Good. Okay. So really turn on your inner thighs. Okay? Use those inner thighs big time, right? Take an inhale as you curl up.
Inhale as I
curl up. But I it feels so good.
Yes.
Now I'm confused. It's technically an inhale.
It is technically. I think that might be too much for her.
I agree. I think
an exhale would be appropriate. Yeah, okay. So take a nice big inhale now. Okay, and as you exhale, bring your chin towards your chest. You come out of the water. Inhale. Up. So I want to be here and there.
You don't want to be there.
Okay, but did you know this?
I'm trying. Here, she said she's afraid she's going to fall. This is how you roll down. Roll back down. If you're holding on your back, you're very likely to tip her too far. Or she's not going to know which way she's going. You have the most control here. And you could push it to your legs. Just let roll up.
This is a roll, and then this starts to loosen up there, right?
That also gives her some more support.
So the biggest challenge of the statue.
And look up. There you go. And then here I can really support her. Roll down, roll through your spine. But whether you're holding at her ankles or supporting her here, you've got the most control over where her body goes if you've got that top and bottom. Try that. And try both ways. Try once with just your hands and once with your belly.
Okay. So take an inhale as you come
up. So don't move your hands. You're there to help her not feel like she's going to fall. And you'll feel why
Inhale and curl up.
Downward pressure on your legs. And then you put your bottom hand is there to make sure it doesn't go too low.
Doesn't go too low.
Your legs need to be a little higher, ideally. Right. Yeah, there you go.
That's it. Inhale, curl down.
Good. So you're she's like most people on this exercise, quad dominant, so the quads are helping her get through the tight quads in her back.
Right.
So by putting downward pressure on her legs, you're actually helping her the quad dominant a little bit, but it's something to give on. So she's got more flexibility in her back and more confidence in the exercise. But then you've got your hand underneath so you don't push her so hard that her legs drop.
Oh, right.
And at different points in the movement, you're going to need to support it differently, which we've talked about.
Right.
So I would, with somebody who's not confident, it's a good.
Stay here and use that up and down. Right. I like you get that.
But as soon as if she's not confident in her balance, or if she doesn't have the balance, as soon as you start touching other parts of her body, there's the chance of her flying off, or just feeling like she's going to fly.
So
we're messing with you. Yeah, sure. So heels come together.
Have a seat on the box facing me.
Pick
four fingers and see if you can fit them behind your bottom, and they'll be on the edge of the box.
I
Good? Yes. All right. All right, so good. Legs apart, ankles flexed, feet flexed. So we're going to do round back, give yourself a low hug under your ribs, right? Here, feel like your shoulders are down, okay, but you're round, okay? Take an exhale as you come forward.
Yes, there you
and
go.
And now inhale, and keeping that back curvature, and then inhale back. Press against the carriage with your thighs. Keep looking down. And exhale. Engage the hot car seat analogy here. So feel like you're on a hot car seat, okay? And everything is good. Inhale back. Keep looking down. Good. And exhale forward.
Your hands
are on the thighs. The more hot car seat you can do. You know when you get into a hot car seat, you can squeeze everything in together. It might be narrowing the pelvis. We're going to say over there.
Is that similar?
It's similar. That feeling that everything is sort of pulled into the center. Around your whole middle section.
Yeah.
Feel the difference? A little bit?
Feel a lot.
Perfect.
Grab the short box pole. So we did round back, now we did flat back. Raise it up so that your head is between your between your ears. Okay? Big nice and tall. And you're going to hinge back on the inhale. And looking down. At your feet. Exhale forward. So you still have that. Narrowing the pelvis feeling, okay? Connected in the end, and your thin shins against the carriage, and exhale.
And so we have
and last one, inhale. Good. Yeah. Keep your arms between your ears, and we're going to do a lateral bend, okay? So bend to the right first with an inhale.
I think it is.
And exhale to the center. Lean a little bit more forward. Feel like you're coming longer in your midsection. And exhale to the center.
And James is like, he sticks out
to the right arm. Shoulder blades down. That's it. Good. And back to the center. Okay. Now then the last one, you're going to... Okay, so now we'll just do a twist. Okay, so it's a twist from the waist, all right, to the right. And exhale to the center. Try and keep that bar between your head between the arms, right? And exhale. A bit more forward. Good. Long in the middle section. Narrow that pelvis. To the left. And back to the center. Now. Twist to the right.
Now what you're
going to do, how can you support her? Just
push
her
arms
down. Just how can you support her and get her arms overhead?
Don't cut it too far. So you kind of cut it short for you.
That would address what you're getting ready to say.
Moving as one piece, as strong as you can.
Shoulder blades down your back.
So well, to stay really tall.
I'm thinking partnering. What would you partner her?
Well, I could grab the bar.
I would do that.
Yeah. Okay. So,
grab from back. And you want to be pushing from the underside.
Let's just see how it goes. We might
be pushing up, however it makes sense to be able to either pull or push to give her height.
Like she, with straight elbows, she's pushing up, you're pushing up.
I want you pushing up.
So your goal is to get your leg down, spread
right.
out.
There you go. So, now twist to the right. Now what I want you to do is to come on a diagonal, bend back towards me on a diagonal.
Really work in high control. This is where the thing is.
And exhale to the center.
You're shifting your
twist.
Forward.
On a diagonal.
Very
well.
And keep pulling
your eyebrows. In the back, she's going to need it the most.
Yes, there you go.
She's going to need it the most.
Good. Now, bend your knees.
There you go. And then it starts to move the left side of the neck and your back.
The last one.
Not too low. Good. But we're low enough for your challenge.
I think it's not.
And you're going to open on your legs.
Did that help at all?
A lot. Okay, good. I like that. You can put the pole down.
It doesn't
good.
Have the,
yeah. So now we're going to go to side sit up.
So, stack your hips on the right side. So, go onto your right side. So would you like a pad? It's going to be under your thigh, actually. Yes. Eventually your IT band. Yeah. So this is the one, right? Right hand on the shoulder rest, and left hand can be, yep, back here, or you can put both hands back here. As I recall, you've done that before. Okay, so that's fine. That's great. Make sure you have a good inner thigh connection. Okay, so outer thigh here, inner thighs, and long through the middle of your body, right? And it's going to be an exhale and now an inhale as you pull up.
So now,
right, look up a little bit like you're in two panes of glass, right? Think long. Last one, inhale and exhale, come up. That was three. And exhale, come up, and we'll go to the other side.
That actually up and high.
Good. And now we'll switch up to the other side.
Okay, so how?
And then rest your knees. Okay. Here you go. And switch up. Okay. You don't think the words out. Which way? Good.
Okay.
So, hands behind the head, outer thigh here, inner thigh on both legs. Inhale and exhale. Pull up. Inhale over and exhale. Pull up from your waist. Last one. Inhale and exhale up and now put your hand on the headrest and come facing this way.
Now,
stay with this foot underneath your strap.
Yes.
Yeah.
These are
soft. So I'm wondering, I mean, she's not like got the right amount of distance here for Trini. It's just closer. I'm thinking, should I take the time?
Her box is not, and I can't see her box is not in the right place.
It looked okay before, I thought.
But the box should be against the fence.
Just try those.
It can be this way, but you mean for her?
It can be, but for as a height modification, but I don't think, I mean, it's not.
Okay.
It's not an appropriate spot for her. She needs to be against the peg for that.
Okay, so this
that's your standard setting. Anything else is a modification.
I'm not going to get mine now.
Okay, and that makes sense. It's the most stable
one. Yeah.
Okay, so bring your left hand arm and put it underneath your left leg. Right?
Yeah, I'm going to I just because I'm
take this hand
so
and
hold
your wrist.
Yeah.
All right. Now, what that does is gives you good shoulder stability. Okay. So now straighten that left leg. And inhale and exhale.
Yes.
Last one. Inhale up. Stretch a little bit. And exhale. Stretch up. Flex that foot. One, two, three times.
Do you feel it in your
other foot? Circles in one direction. The other direction?
Just two more, because I don't want to ever.
You can tolerate. Now, take your hands and climb up your tree. Bring your leg to your, bring your knee to your nose. Knee to your nose,
okay.
Right. And walk up, climb up the tree. Inhale, arm goes out.
Right.
Right. Now, come back.
Yeah, now you've
hold
got up,
your elbows out.
You're almost like
back. Good. Straight back a little bit more. Good. Now, take an inhale and climb down the tree.
So
inhale.
Are,
and exhale, keep looking down.
Okay.
Now to the arch layer. Climb up.
Okay.
Knee to the nose a little bit more if you can.
So you might
try to inhale.
You're circling.
It
actually
exhale.
Is it
might be. The nose, a little less chin.
But your hips in conjunction
with your legs. And an arch if you want.
Your way, like that. Yeah.
And curl up.
You're over it.
Okay. Grab a hold of your hand, this hand on the inside of your.
All of that. Just the issue.
I was going to do it over the hip.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Pull on the strap. Okay. Now, roll back. Right.
Now the chest is.
Bring your leg out to the side.
Rock yourself up. But.
Oh,
that's a really good.
Thing.
Do you see how easy that is?
Exhale. Now,
come into the side.
Yes.
That's quite a bit better.
You actually got,
there was a spring. So
switch
feet
here.
It's still tight, but it's
the same kind of.
Now you're
going to
hold it down.
Okay.
down, good. Elbows out. In. Extend that leg. Inhale. And exhale. Oh, two.
One, two, three.
And straight up. And now point and flex the foot. And circles. Even here, feel like you're kind of up in your midsection. You know, you're kind of holding yourself up from your belly. Good. And now point your foot. Bring your knee to your nose.
But
without the tree. Inhaling.
That was
out.
Really good. That's the trick. That's the hard part.
Come
the
back.
Part.
Okay. You're better.
You want your shoulders down.
I'm sorry.
You might get
it. Oh.
Sorry.
Yes.
And exhale. Even here, you climb down the tree, then inhale. And
so go straight up. Yeah. Go straight up.
Inhale down. So even now, feel that narrow inner pelvis. Okay. There's like the inner thigh connection happening.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. There you go.
And last one.
And pretty much any exercise
you
do,
chin to your chest first.
I want to show you a quick hands-on crooked thing.
Do
you want me to feel? Go back to being crooked. Okay, so two things tend to happen. They tend to get tight up in here, or the inner thighs are checked out.
Right.
So that's going to bring them right back.
So that when you're without that, for your pushing down,
and then I'm at
your
heel.
Not your shoulders down.
Ideally, I'd be able to
persuade
it. I feel like if I do that, I'm going to be intimate. It's a little bit more fingery, but with my fingers, I can also give her a little more traction in that soft tissue there.
Right, right. And you can do that kind of thing too in single leg circle on the mat.
It's a great hands-on to scooping out the hips. It's a gyro thing. But I've seen the CBC teachers use it as well. Scooping out the hip.
All right. So now you can step up.
So one last thing.
Okay. So do you have
front? Oh yeah.
Wow. Can we keep going?
Yes.
I have 5 more minutes.
5 more minutes. Okay. All right. Let's do some more. Yeah. A little stretch, rather.
You are done, my dear.
Your arms are open.
Okay, so this is the one that you're in a plank position. So bring your left hand and put it here, and your left foot onto the mat, keep straight leg, and right hand, and then right foot.
Sorry.
Yeah.
What? That's okay. Come up off your knees. Stand in the pad. Good. Heels together, toes apart, but your heels are raised up off the mat. Okay. Now, so come into a plank position as you bring the carriage out with an inhale.
So let's review this position there. Step all the way to the floor. So what is the full transition here? So,
are you still squeezing?
I tried.
Well, she shouldn't be on her knees.
Sure.
Right.
So try talking her through. Full
transition.
Okay. Yeah. I did my left leg.
I didn't say straight leg, but she wasn't able to.
Do I have to do my left side first?
It feels good.
I think
no.
Okay. So, is that weird?
Yes. You can do the right side first.
Okay.
There should be some things I think.
No, wait a minute. I have to do it. But if you do it, you can mount it the other way.
Like this?
Okay. You're welcome. Good job.
Right?
Technical setup. Is opposite hand foot. You want the cross of the body to set up for the maximum stability. So it'd be right hand, left foot. If she wants to do her left hand first, I'd have her come to the other side and step directly up.
Right.
So you're here, you're in your plank as soon as your hands and your foot are coming up.
Okay.
So then you're ready to go.
I see your point. I did cue her to put the left one in the left. Yeah. Okay. So right hand and left foot.
Yes, you can. Yes.
Right. Ideal. Right. So this is really common. That your ideal is to get directly into that plank position.
Right.
The springs closed.
Right.
And where else you do that exact same transition in level one, you can move Belching.
Sorry. I want to keep talking to Stephanie, okay. But you can do that.
Inhale. Where else do you do that exact same position in level one?
Yep.
Right. In terms
it's
of mountain.
Preparation. Yeah. It's a preparation for.
Holding the chair again, come to your knees. Bring your feet up to the shoulder pads. Your toes curl back, right? And knees open a little bit more. Shoulder width, right? And so now come forward towards the foot bar. This is upstretch, right? Feel like you're lifting your knees off, even though you're not. Press through your heels. Bring the carriage out. Inhale. And exhale. And two. Inhale. Press it through here. And exhale. Okay, holding the carriage in. Now come up onto flat feet. We're going to go right into elephant action. Okay? So flat feet in front of the shoulder blocks. And curl your belly in a little bit more. Float your toes up.
Oh, yes.
That's it. Inhale out. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two, three. I'm going to come away. Keep holding your belly up and curled back. Two more. Okay, and now you can step off. Let's finish with running. Head way down. That's it. More footwork. And then head and shoulder to shoulder pad. Good. Feet and knees together. Good. Nice inner thigh connection. Take an inhale, bring the carriage out. And run in place. Take a nice heavy pelvis. Let's get back to some nice deep breathing. And exhale. Good. So when you come out, don't just drop into the knee. Okay, keep the hamstrings turned on. Okay, and even your glute turned on a little bit. So there's a slight bend in here. It's not just dropped. You're still controlling it. And two more. And last one. Straighten both legs. Bend them. Bend your knees and bring carriage in. Come to pelvic lift. Float your pelvis up about a fist width. And take your arm out and take an inhale, bring the carriage out. And exhale.
Now just going around.
Inhale, two. Exhale. Three. We are think long in your midsection. You're really standing in your feet when you have your legs. Right now you're standing in your feet totally. Yes. Inner thighs. Even acting here, right? Okay. A little bit of that hot car seat and bikini muscles. And last one. Inhale and exhale, holding the carriage in. Start to lower from your upper spine to your lower, and so I would normally have her do something standing, but we're at a little bit of time. Thank you, Kalshane.
Thank you.
Good job.